assaulting a Portland police officer during that fight. Stephen Hay was sentenced to 5 months in jail. A follow-up tonight on Consumers Buyline. We first told you about Consumers Buyline last May when the company was accused of being an illegal pyramid scheme that uses unfair sales practices to sign up new members. Tonight, consumer reporter Ursula Lipari tells us some members of that multi-level direct marketing group now say Consumers Buyline is not offering members all that it promised, and they're leaving the company.
On Saturday night, more than 200 Maine Consumers Buyline members packed into this Biddeford theater, all looking to meet the man behind the company, President Keith Raniere. But Raniere did not show up, and some say, as a result, the meeting got nasty.
It was pretty exciting, I guess, from a point of view of people wanted answers. I think he decided he didn't need the state of Maine.
Some former Consumers Buyline members say what happened here Saturday night simply confirms something they've been suspecting all along, that the company out of New York just can't handle the thousands and thousands of members it has here in Maine and nationwide. Furthermore, the company cannot address a growing number of questions and complaints. To understand what happened, first you need to know how Consumers Buyline, Inc., or CBI, works. It's a multi-level marketing company. Memberships cost about $219 a year. For that, members get access to discount buying groups, but they also may earn money selling CBI memberships, for which they are supposed to get bonuses and a monthly commission. According to CBI's own brochure, after selling only two memberships, you could make more than $4,000 a month. But according to members like Bob Harnish, many times that has not happened. And he says not only has the highly promoted discount grocery program Harvest America been discontinued without proper notice, the company continues to charge people for it. Andy says CBI is not paying its members what it owes them.
They overtax their capital, and they're robbing Peter to pay Paul.
Another CBI member who signed up early on in November, Dave Caton, says he's quitting Consumers Buyline, too.
The problem has never been with the membership. The problem has been with the affiliateship and people getting paid, taken care of, getting promised what they were doing. If you go to work, you want to get paid at the end of the week. And that's the bottom line with people.
And people aren't getting paid.
Not that I've heard.
Caden and Harnish don't believe accusations that Consumers Buyline is an illegal pyramid scheme. In fact, both believe multi-level marketing companies like CBI are the wave of the future. But in this case, they say the idea may work, but the company does not. Ursula Lipari, NewsCenter.
Now, efforts to reach Consumers Buyline's president or legal counsel were unsuccessful today. So far, the company is facing four state investigations and several state lawsuits. As a result of one of those lawsuits, Consumers Buyline will no longer sell memberships in the state of Arkansas. Here in Maine, the Androscoggin County District Attorney has demanded CBI return all of the money sent in or drafted out of members' bank accounts. DA Janet Mills says she considers the activities of Consumers Buyline to be illegal. Coming up next on NewsCenter.